So this is kind of the basic stuff, right? I want to spend maybe another maybe 50, 10 minutes, right? Not more than that. And very quickly jump to, what path, like what advice do these our panelists have for the audience? I presume there are a few students, and maybe even some faculty who are interested in starting companies or whatever. So what path should someone take, right? And what are ways to don't know, right, whether you want to start a campaign or you're afraid of the risk, right, that you need to take. What are some ways to make it more calculated than as Dan would suggest, so that more folks feel comfortable taking the risk?
Well, one of the most important thing is the persistence. And here we have a lot of people that have got PhDs and computer science, so persistence in writing programs, persistence in doing anything is built into what we do. When you've got a team and you've got to convince them that we need to do this, this can be done, you've got to be persistent. You've got to, the glass is always half full. It's very easy to get yourself worked into a rut where you want to give up. So you've just got to stick with it. That's number one. And many times there are a lot of forces, financial forces, competitive forces. Large companies are doing things. As a small company, you have to be a gazelle. You have to be nimble. You have to be faster than the larger companies. Larger companies move at Titanic speeds. But you just got to dance around them and learn how to work with them. So that takes a little bit of art to understand where the market trends are, what the customer trends are, what the competitive trends, what are the large companies doing, what are the industry trends. You've got to really bring all those together and really be a gazelle in whatever you do. You've got to be faster to market and stick with it. So that's really my recommendation is just be fast at whatever it is that you're going to do, get it out there as quickly as you can as a highly reliable, well-tested technology, and have your team 100% behind you.
So what he's saying is, it doesn't matter if you're an undergrad or grad or whatever else, if you have an idea for a product, get it out into the marketplace as quickly as possible. Try and sell it to people, understand what your other competitors are doing or could be doing, right? So you can't just be focused on the technology, but you need to understand the market as well, right?
I totally agree. I think one of the roles of small companies is to go fast and do things that large companies can't do on exactly the same schedule. Therefore, one of the opportunities small companies have is to partner with big companies, do things they can't on timelines they can't, and find ways to monetize the results of those partnerships. Those are difficult deals. You have to be absolutely shameless when you go in and ask for the check, but there is an interesting thing about a small company working with a big company. It puts a level of process and discipline into your company very early on that otherwise would be a significant investment. And entrepreneurs have a tendency to think about reasons for putting certain things off, and it's always the bureaucratic and administrative stuff. Dan mentioned risk, and he's exactly right. If there were some way to measure a person's tolerance for taking risk, I don't know if there's a standard measure for that. I suspect that you would find out that there's 100% correlation that people who are likely to get into an entrepreneurial lifestyle are intolerant, very tolerant of risk. And I would suggest it's on two different dimensions. The first is you can go home and sleep at night, even though there might be 50 different things swirling around that need to be taken. Well, I presume you get to come on that night. But the other issue is the reward factor associated with risk is out much further in the future than most people are thinking about. It's not on Friday. It might be 5, it might be 10 years from now. So your ability to expose yourself and construct yourself and deal with it and manage it and then wait for it are all factors. Now, I will tell you that the university and the community also has a role here. We can't do it all ourselves. The community shouldn't be punishing entrepreneurs for failing. It should be praising them for stepping out and taking the risk down then, and tolerating a little bit of failure. As soon as that's the message that is sent continuously, you'll see far more people step out, take a little bit of risk. And the more people we have, this is just a numbers game. The more tolerant and encouraging the community is of risk takers, the more growth, the more businesses that we'll see. Things have changed significantly in Buffalo. We're not Silicon Valley. You know, we have a little ways to go.
What advice would you give?
Advice, and really the way that I've, and with my last company, and I think a really good way for people who do have a day job but are still, they have an idea and not sure if it's going to work. And I tell this a lot to a lot of people, where a lot of people go home at night and they'll watch TV, they'll watch Netflix, they'll do some other stuff, and there's this whole gap and this whole time in your day that most people just kind of waste. And utilizing that time and working on your passions, working on your ideas, and seeing what comes from it. And once you get to that point where during the day you can't stop thinking about just going and working on this other thing, you've kind of realized that that's the point at which you should take that leap. But the good part of that is that it's more about taking risk, but calculated risk, where you now have maybe some semblance of a product. You've talked to some customers already. You've talked to some other people. And you may have a team now. You may have one other person, two other people that are joining along. So I think that's good advice for people who have that day job and really say, well, how can I start this company? It's, well, you need to do your day job and you go home, and then you eat dinner, and then you have until 4 in the morning or whatever, you pass out to work on that. So that's great advice that gets you further enough along to feel comfortable to take the jump. But at the same time, I mentioned team, ensuring that you have at least one other person that's along with you on the journey, because it's so hard, and things always take longer. There's way too much to do. Even if you had 10 people, there's still way too much to do. And to throw that all on one person, it's always good to have somebody else to pass something off to. Depending on how long you're building and developing the product, there's highs and lows, and it's always good to have somebody else to counter those highs or counter those lows. But those are all my advice. It's basically do what you can until you need to jump, and make sure you have a team going with you. So.
That's great. Rohini, any
advice?
Any advice? And if so, yeah, go on.
Sure. So one of the things I think that people don't realize, especially people who have developed some technology, want to commercialize it, and this is great technology, I'm going to start a company, I'm going to market this, whatever. They really need to pause and think about, is this something that they really want to take on? Commercialization of existing technology, that's a lot of what I've done, is taken some raw technology, built a product. I love building products now. I think I'm pretty good at it now. That's what I really do. But I think one has to also be prepared for a lot of multitasking. Within an hour, you might be doing 6 totally different kinds of things. You might be talking to lawyers, you might be talking to CFO, looking at spreadsheets, you might be talking to your marketing person, your product development person, and most probably, customers also. So it's, and you have to have, even though there's parts of it that you really relate to and like doing, you have to be prepared to do a little bit of everything. It, of course, you will hire people to serve all those roles, but it doesn't mean that you can just let go of all the other stuff. So staying involved in all aspects of a company, I think, is important for success. And the last piece of it is being very passionate about what you're doing, and you know, really that this is something that you really want to do. It's your life's mission. The kinds of things that I've been seeing this year, I've been working with a lot of social entrepreneurs who are really amazing, and it's not, you know, because of the really high-flown technology, it's the applications that they're working on, and I mean, it's really, I can't say how inspiring it is to be around these social entrepreneurs. There's this one team that I'm working with, you know, they've built these very, very cheap sensors, and they're able now to provide 3 to 4 minute advance warning of an impending airstrike that could kill people. So they've developed this technology, but this is where the entrepreneurship comes in, because they're not making a lot of money on solving that problem, but they figured out that those same sensors, acoustic sensors, can be sold to cities to judge where traffic problems may be existing and so on. So they figured out a way of monetizing that. So this is the kind of entrepreneurship that I think is great, where you're solving some problem, but you also figure out a way of monetizing it. And so hopefully that type of industry will grow.